Walt loved music. He really did. And he felt that that was one ingredient in a good film.
Walt wanted his people really to do what they wanted and what they felt was right. And for example, he would set the tone. I mean, he would select the story and say, I want these people to work on this particular story.
Well, it sounds pretty good. In fact, that's just the right spirit.
In an animated film, usually the script is the storyboard. And we look at the storyboards and discuss with the story team what situation they need and what they wanted.
Then we write the song that we think will fit and we play it for them. And then they fit the storyboards to our song.
We knew right away that we wanted to have a French flavor for our songs, and in particular the title song. We wanted it to really set the mood and the style, and it told the story of the Aristocats, who are very aristocratic, special little pussycats that are taken care of and tended to, and of course they had their great adventure. And I think the story has a great deal of charm. It has a great deal of whimsy, excitement. The chase sequence is unbelievable, that chase in the country, that midnight howl is hysterical. I mean, there's so many great pieces of animation going on in the show. And the title song, of course, we kept saying, it's too bad Chevalier retired. He'd be perfect for this. He's Mr. Paris, but he had gone into retirement.
Well, Willie Reitherman, the director of the film, said, look, Dick, make a demo. The way you imitate him, make a demo of the song, and we'll get it to him.
And see, maybe he'll come out of retirement to do it. So I girded my loins, and again, I did my Chevalier imitation.
Which pet's address is the finest in Paris? Which pets possess the longest pedigree? To which pets do the others tip their hats? Naturellement, the Aristocats.
Well, I did the whole song like that, and we sent it off to Chevalier. And happily, he came out of retirement, and the very last professional work he ever did, the last recording, was the soundtrack to our wonderful picture, Aristocats.
And he imitated Dick.
Which pet's address is the finest in Paris? Which pets possess the longest pedigree? Which pets get to sleep on velvet mats? Naturellement, the Aristocats.
Now, dear, you go to the piano. Now, run along. Both of you go ahead.
The scales and arpeggios again showed, set the characters of the little cats being taught their artistic ways. And so we based everything on the actual sound of scales being played and arpeggios being played. And out came this little song that the pussycat sang.
Every truly cultured music student knows you must learn your scales and your arpeggios. Bring the music ringing from your chest and not your nose while you sing your scales and your arpeggios.
If you're faithful to your daily practicing, you will find your progress is encouraging. Do me, so me, do me, so me, follow so it goes. When you do your skills and your arpeggios.
And as we go on, we learn about the artist. He has to do his thing, and we had lines. Let's see, where we go.
Do me so do do so me do me so do do so me. Train yourself to draw a line that's straight and true. Then your brush will do just what you want it to. If you study, you won't muddy up each brilliant hue. Practicing your painting is the thing to do.